In this video, we're going to explore the tricky topic of research gaps, also sometimes called literature gaps. We'll explain what a research gap is, look at the four most common types of research gaps, and unpack how you can go about finding a suitable research gap for your dissertation, thesis, or research project. Speaking of which, if you're currently working on a dissertation or thesis, be sure to grab our free dissertation templates to help fast track your write-up. These tried and tested templates provide a detailed roadmap to guide you through each chapter, section by section. If that sounds helpful, you can find the link in the description below. So what exactly is a research gap? Well, at the simplest level, a research gap is essentially an unanswered question or unresolved problem in a field, which reflects a lack of existing research in that space. Alternatively, a research gap can also exist when there's already a fair deal of existing research, but where the findings of the studies pull in different directions, making it difficult to draw firm conclusions. For example, let's say your research aims to identify the cause or causes of a particular disease. Upon reviewing the literature, you may find that there's a body of research that points towards cigarette smoking as a key factor, but at the same time, a large body of research that finds no link between smoking and the disease. In that case, you may have something of a research gap that warrants further investigation. So, now that we've defined what a research gap is, an unanswered question or unresolved problem, let's look at the four most common types of research gaps. While there are many different types of research gaps, the four most common ones we encounter when helping students at Grad Coach are as follows. Number one, the classic literature gap. Number two, the disagreement gap. Number three, the contextual gap. And number four, the methodological gap. Let's take a look at each of them. First up is the classic literature gap. This type of research gap emerges when there's a new concept or phenomenon that hasn't been studied much or at all. For example, when a social media platform is launched, there's an opportunity to explore its impacts on users, how it could be leveraged for marketing, its impact on society, and so on. The same applies for new technologies, new modes of communication, transportation, etc. Classic literature gaps can present exciting research opportunities, but a drawback you need to be aware of is that with this type of research gap, you'll be exploring completely new territory. This means you'll have to draw on adjacent literature, that is, research in adjacent fields, to build your literature review, as there naturally won't be very many existing studies that directly relate to the topic. While this is manageable, it can be challenging for first-time researchers, so be careful not to bite off more than you can chew. The next type of research gap is the disagreement gap. As the name suggests, the disagreement gap emerges when there are contrasting or contradictory findings in the existing research regarding a specific research question or set of questions. The hypothetical example we looked at earlier regarding the causes of a disease reflects a disagreement gap. Importantly, for this type of research gap, there needs to be a relatively balanced set of opposing findings. In other words, a situation where 95% of studies find one result and 5% find the opposite wouldn't quite constitute a disagreement in the literature. Of course, it's hard to quantify exactly how much weight to give to each study, but you'll need to at least show that the opposing findings aren't simply a corner case anomaly. The third type of research gap is the contextual gap. Simply put, a contextual gap exists when there's already a decent body of existing research on a particular topic, but an absence of research in specific contexts. For example, there could be a lack of research on a specific population, perhaps a certain age group, gender, or ethnicity, a geographic area, for example, a city, country, or region, a certain time period, Perhaps the bulk of the studies took place many years or even decades ago, and the landscape has changed. The contextual gap is a popular option for dissertations and theses, especially for first-time researchers, as it allows you to develop your research on a solid foundation of existing literature and potentially even use existing survey measures. Importantly, if you're going to go this route, you need to ensure that there's a plausible reason why you'd expect potential differences in the specific context you choose. If there's no reason to expect different results between existing and new contexts, the research gap wouldn't be well justified. So, make sure that you can clearly articulate why your chosen context is different from existing studies, and why that might reasonably result in different findings. If you're enjoying this video so far, please help us out by hitting that like button. You can also subscribe for loads of plain language, actionable advice. If you're new to research, check out our free dissertation writing course, which covers everything you need to get started on your research project. As always, links in the description. All right, last but not least, we have the methodological gap. As the name suggests, this type of research gap emerges as a result of the research methodology or design of existing studies. With this approach, you'd argue that the methodology of existing studies is lacking in some way, or that they're missing a certain perspective. For example, you might argue that the bulk of the existing research has taken a quantitative approach, and therefore there is a lack of rich insight and texture that a qualitative study could provide. Similarly, you might argue that existing studies have primarily taken a cross-sectional approach, and as a result, have only provided a snapshot view of the situation, whereas a longitudinal approach could help uncover how variables have evolved over time. By the way, if you're keen to learn more about cross-sectional and longitudinal studies, check out our video about that up here. Now that you've got a clearer picture of the different types of research gaps, the next question is, of course, how do you find these research gaps? Well, we cover the process of how to find original, high-value research gaps and, by extension, research topics in a separate video, which you can find up here. But for now, I'll share a basic two-step strategy here to help you find potential research gaps. As a starting point, you should find as many literature reviews, systematic reviews, and meta-analyses as you can, covering your area of interest. Additionally, you should dig into the most recent journal articles to wrap your head around the current state of knowledge. It's also a good idea to look at recent dissertations and theses, especially doctoral level ones. Dissertation databases such as ProQuest, EBSCO, and Open Access are a goldmine for this sort of thing. We'll include the links to those below. Importantly, make sure that you're looking at recent resources, ideally those published in the last year or two, or the gaps you find might have already been plugged by other researchers. Once you've gathered a meaty collection of resources, the section that you really want to focus on is the one titled Further Research Opportunities, or Further Research is Needed. In this section, the researchers will explicitly state where more studies are required. In other words, where potential research gaps may exist. You can also look at the limitations section of the studies, as this will often spur ideas for methodology-based research gaps. By following this process, you'll orient yourself with the current state of research, which will lay the foundation for you to identify potential research gaps. You can then start drawing up a short list of ideas and evaluating them as candidate topics. But remember, make sure you're looking at recent articles. There's no use going down a rabbit hole only to find that someone's already filled the gap. If you got value from this video, please hit that like button to help more students find this content. For more videos like this, check out the Grad Coach channel and subscribe for plain language, actionable research tips and advice every week. Also, if you're looking for one-on-one support with your dissertation, thesis, or research project, be sure to check out our private coaching service, where we hold your hand throughout the research process step by step. You can learn more about that and book a free initial consultation at gradcoach.com.